गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, आई होप यू ऑल आर फाइन एंड गुड। टुडे वी विल सी द कंपोजर इंटरफेस। बिफोर वी स्टार्ट द कंपोजर इंटरफेस, लेट अस सी सम ब्रीफ इंट्रोडक्शन अबाउट कंपोजर। अबाउट कंपोजर, फर्स्ट, it is a free open source web development IDE. So here three important terms coming here. Open source whose development coding is available to modify, not proprietary. That means the development coding of the software is available along with the downloaded copy. If anybody wants to modify the software configuration or anybody wants to add something new features into Composer, if they know the programming, they can modify the software. Second thing is, it is not a proprietary. That means it is not designed by any private company and it is not sold under any strict licensing policy. Basically, all the open source softwares, almost all open source softwares are available freely over internet. Okay, next term is web development. What is web development? That is a designing web pages and websites. Third term is IDE. IDE stands for Integrated Development Environment. It provides complete facilities of web development to the web designer. That means it provides all the features to design the web page, to modify the content and to upload the page over server. Okay, next thing, it can be downloaded from www.composer.net. It has a simple editor known as WYSIWYG. Now what is that? It is what you see is what you get. It is a name of editor. What you see is what you get means whatever the content you are designing, where you are putting into the page, the exactly same thing will be displayed on the browser. So finally, Composer is a complete web authoring system which integrates the web page development and web file management. Means we can design the web page and all the design web pages we can store at particular place, and from that place we can upload it over the server. Next thing is site manager. Site manager is most significant component of the Composer IDE, which gives rapid access to the file on both local machines and remote server. So it is a component of Composer through which we can manage our created file which are stored in our computer, and also we can manage all the files, all the web pages which are already uploaded over server. Okay. We can directly upload the web pages over web page directly through Composer. As it is said, we have a powerful tool called Site Manager. So through Site Manager, we can upload the web pages directly from the Composer screen. Composer supports CSS too. What is CSS? That is Cascading Style Sheet. That will be discussed in chapter number 2. Okay, major components of a Composer interface. Before we start with the Composer screen, let us see some important components: title bar, menu bar, composition toolbar, formatting toolbar 1, formatting toolbar 2, task pane or various task tab. It is also referred as site manager also, right? So it contains the site manager, FTP console, DOM explorer, etc. Page tab, page area, edit modes. Now three types of edit modes are there, that is normal, HTML tags and preview. Designing tabs, here also three designing tabs are there: design, split and source. Now What are that components? How they are working in composer screen? That we will see. Okay, in this PPT part, that's all. Okay, now we will move to the composer interface. Now composer, as we know, can be downloaded from www.composer.net. If we are working over Windows, we have to download and install the software. If we have Linux operating system, then composer is by default available as a part of system. Okay, so here I am using Windows, so I'll start with the composer screen. Okay, so this is your composer interface. This first thing is your title bar. Now whatever the page we are creating and saving, the name of that page will be displayed in a title bar. Second is a menu bar. As we all know, menu bar contain various menu items for creating the web page and web elements. Next is composition toolbar. This is your composition toolbar. This is a composition toolbar. Now composition toolbar, formatting toolbar, all these toolbars contain the menu items which are frequently used from menu bar. Okay, so new, open, edit, may select, undo, redo, cut, copy, paste, view, insert, different elements or different menu items which are frequently used from the menu bar are given into the composition toolbar, formatting toolbar 1 and formatting toolbar 2. From composition toolbar we can create the web page and add various elements like image, table, form elements, form controls, and even add CSS. At the same time we can publish our web page over the server also. For that we need to do certain settings. Okay, next is formatting toolbar 1 and formatting toolbar 2, that is used for text level formatting. Means whatever the text we have entered, we need to format it. We may need to change the color, change it into bold, underline, italic. We may need to change the alignment, etc. For that we are using formatting toolbar 1 and 2. Now below that we can see our window is split into two parts. First part is your task tab or task pane, we can say, which is also referred as site manager, and second is your page area. Now here you can see in the task pane, left side pane, we can see the site manager, FTP console, DOM explorer. Now this DOM explorer displays all the elements which are created in the page, which are a part of HTML coding that we can see here. Okay, I'll show the same page which is created through composer. In the last part we will see the page. Okay, now this site manager or task tab can be opened or closed using F9 button. I'm pressing here F9. You can see the site manager is removed from the screen. Again by pressing F9 key it is visible. Okay, next is a page tab. Here it is a page tab. Now composer provides the facility to work with multiple pages in the same screen or single screen. So here I can open multiple pages and all the pages will be displayed in a tab. Okay, now currently selected tab will display all its content in a page area. This is your page area. This is the main working area of our composer screen. Whatever the content you want to put, whatever the controls you want to create, that all must be given within this page area only. Okay, next thing is edit modes. Now here you can see here a selection list or drop down list. Here this is your edit mode. Now three edit modes are there: preview, normal and HTML tags. Okay, now how it works, that we will see in a actual page. Okay, next three is a design, split and source. Okay, these are the designing tabs, design tab, split tab and source. Now how it will work, let us open one page. I am opening from here, open registration form. Now you can see the created page is displayed over here. Let us see edit mode. In the normal mode, it will display all these outlines of tables, elements, form controls, etc. If we select preview, then it will display the page how it will be displayed on a browser. It is showing without any borderline or any outline. Okay. Now preview is only for viewing our web page. Okay, it will not run any script. If we have defined any script in the web page, it will not any script. It will not run any script. Now next is HTML tags. By selecting this, we can see all the tags which are used in the structure that is given as a yellow tooltip over here. This is your body, this is your form control, then heading, then table structure. Within the table structure, first TD, second TD, in the second TD, it is input control created. All these things can be seen as a HTML tags. Now here, this designing tab, first design tab will show you the visual display, how web page is designed, how the controls are designed. In a split tab, it will display the coding of only selected control or selected element. For example, suppose I am selecting this. This is input control. So I can see here the coding of that input control only. I am selecting here normal, so you can easily understand it. If I am selecting this one, I can see the coding of input control only. Suppose I am selecting this selection list, then I can see the coding of selection list. Okay, in the source part, I can see the coding of entire web page, how the web page can be created if we are using HTML coding. The entire coding is displayed over here. Now student, if we are working over Composer, we are working through Composer, we don't need to type all this coding. Simply we have to design over here and the source will automatically generate the corresponding HTML coding. Okay, so this is your Composer interface. In next part we will see how to create the web pages through Composer. Okay, so that's all for today. Go through the video, learn it carefully. Okay, and most importantly, during this pandemic time, stay home, stay safe. Thank you.